You will feel your bones burn.
Thank you. Thank you. Minimum.
Ha 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 ha!
Deliver.
Thanks to my conversation with Prince Ovengel, I finally understood why the Sons of Arthurion allied themselves with the Heralds of Yule. Arthurion and his descendants loved the gift of immortality and the otherwise unobtainable power that came with it. But for some reason, the king and his descendants lost their gifts. Arthurion, who had lived many more years than any other mortal, was rapidly consumed by the return of those years. However, he did not die. Yule, the guardian of souls, took his nearly dormant body and preserved it in the twilight of Numbria. Yule promised the princes that if they served him, the life of their father would be restored, and they would once again enjoy the gifts that were once bestowed upon them. So it was then that the princes conquered the villages and took the temples. They sent their prisoners to the temple where they were sacrificed by the heralds. The souls of their victims returned to Yule, restoring his power and aiding him in his campaign against the rest of the lords of Shulima. Does this mean that immortality can be more of a curse than a gift? How would others have dealt with such a dilemma? The chance to be reunited with the one you love, in addition to the promise of immortality. And in exchange, the price you pay is sacrificing thousands of your brothers. What would others do in such a situation? What would I have done? They chose, and their fate was decided. The line of Arthurion was lost forever.
Thank you. What do you need?
How can I help you? Farewell.
Greetings. May the light of the gods illuminate your path.
Good day, sir. Come back soon. Welcome, my friend.